Before cell phone cameras, people used these babies with film and dark rooms, and when you were done shooting, you took your stuff to Photomat. I had my little Kodak X15 Instamatic with magic cubes and everything. And some artists are fortunate enough to straddle both worlds, the film world and the digital world. And we're here with one of those photographers, the very talented Sara Stadtmiller. We're here in Neptune at her home. And I know you as a Jersey girl, but you were born in Michigan, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I was born in Michigan. We moved here when I was about 2 or 3 years old. And then my parents split and my dad moved back to Michigan where he was from. And mm-hmm. so I would spend summers and vacations there and then actually spent 7th and 8th grade and 11th and 12th grade there as well.
Okay. And are those trips where you met Gary?
Yep, I met Gary in 7th grade. He was in 8th.
We're talking about Gary Mellon, who was our first featured artist in our very first episode, who is Sara's husband. So your dad was a musician, right?
Yep, my dad, he played in a band all my life. That's how he supported himself. So mm-hmm. That definitely informed the freedom I had to choose a career in art.
Sure. So what point did the photography come in?
In high school, my freshman year of high school here in New Jersey, I took a media graphics course that had like a photography portion to it with the darkroom and everything. And mm-hmm. I had a knack for it. It came pretty easy to me and I felt good at it and mm-hmm. Just felt right. And that was that.
Mm-hmm. Did you continue on to art school with majoring in photography?
I did. I went to Montclair State for mm-hmm. art and I was an art major with a studio concentration in photography.
Mm-hmm. So after you did the commercial scene?
Yeah, right after, I mean, I went to school for art, hoping to make art mm-hmm. as a living. Right after school, I started working at full-time in darkrooms, 2 days a week in a black and white darkroom for a portrait photographer in Red Bank, and 3 days a week in a commercial color darkroom working mm. for blowing up other enlargements for professional photographers. So it was a couple years of 40 hours a week in darkrooms, which was pretty great.
So you don't have to deal with chemicals anymore, right?
Yeah.
Except in your own work, because you still do it old school style.
Yes. I still shoot with, like, this camera is a film camera. This Hasselblad takes 120 film. Both of these images were made from that camera. Mm. I call that one the dream machine.
Yeah, they're indestructible. So speaking of your work, were there any people you worked with or teachers you had that were an influence on your fine art aspect of photography?
Well, my main professor at Montclair, Klaus Schnitzer, was definitely a huge influence on me. And he introduced Hiroshi Sugimoto to me. That was probably the biggest first fine art artist that really hit me as a work I wanted to emulate. Mm-hmm. He did a series of long exposures with seascapes and with these movie theaters that kind of took this moment of time that photography captures this fraction of a second and expanded on mm-hmm. it, extended it.
Well, living so close to the Jersey Shore, must come in handy.
Yes,
you still use it to inform your work, the long exposure.
Mm-hmm. And I did a whole series of my own seascapes right here along mm-hmm. up and down. And it's something I still think about and enjoy doing.
Yeah. Well, your work is gorgeous. And if you want to see more of it, go to sarastadtmiller.com, sarastadtmiller.com. And let's sign off with Sara's greatest creation, if I may say. Lovely Luna, who's 10 months old now?
Yep, just see, over 10 months.
You're going to be famous someday, kid. You're going to be a picture. she agrees with me. So we'll see you next time. Thanks, John, our photographer. We'll see you next time on 5 Minutes with the Cat.
Good job, Luna.
Good job, kid.